Alright, hello guys. My name is Ahmed Mukhtar. Today's topic is not about motivation or sports videos. So this one is about Corona, COVID-19. Past couple of days I've been thinking about this situation. Finally, I got an idea. The main idea is how to control the number of COVID-19 patients. How to stop COVID-19 from spreading out. I'm gonna say some points. I'm gonna try to explain in brief. This is gonna be a bit long, so I hope you guys watch it until the end. Then you can comment below. I hope you watch until the end. First point is all countries supposed to do this idea together at once, because if let's say 9 countries did the idea and the other countries didn't do, means that this COVID-19 will spread out again. The first point, lockdown for 24 hours. Second point is close all the public transports. Okay, I'm gonna explain these 2 points, then I'm gonna go for the rest. The first point is why we need to lock down 24 hours instead of doing the lockdown until 5 p.m., until 4 p.m., some other countries until 3 p.m., and some other countries until 7 p.m. I'm not saying that they did the wrong decision or the right decision. I'm just saying here that there is no point of doing the lockdown until 3 p.m. or the lockdown until 2 p.m. Because for me, for my opinion, if there is still people are going outside, the patients number would be more higher, and then COVID-19 will still have the opportunity to spread out. So we are not gonna be able to stop this thing. As you can see, many countries, they did this 14 days lockdown, so they keep on renewing 14 days after 14 days after 14 days, and the patients number is still going higher, still going higher. So there is no point of this. Means that we are wasting time. Means that we are wasting time, and the results is losing people's lives. So we have to stop this thing. The only way is a 24-hour lockdown. So now the questions in your mind would say, so how am I going to be able to buy supplies? How am I going to be able to go to the grocery? Or how am I gonna be able to go to the clinic? Or how am I gonna be able to go to the hospital? Okay, I'm gonna explain all of these. Okay, but first I need to talk about the public transport. You need to close it also, because from the main reasons for spreading out the COVID-19 to people, it's from the main reasons. So I need to close it also. I need to stay away from any risk. Do not risk with 1%. Do not risk. Because this 1% can be 10%, can be 20% risky, can be 50% risky, can be 100% risky. So you lost all this effort, you lost everything, and you are losing people's lives. Because I didn't take an effective decision. Until now, none of the governments around the world gave a date for the end of COVID-19. Until now, none of the governments gave like a final decision about how to end the COVID-19. Just tell you, stay at home and we'll do our best. Okay, I know that all governments around the world, they are doing their best, but that's why we need to try something new, something that might be effective. And I'm sure this one will be effective, because if all people are at home for 24 hours, we can stop the COVID-19 from spreading out. Then we can control the number of patients, because we are not gonna have any patients anymore, because each person is staying at home for the 24 hours. So if we stop the number of patients, if we stop getting affected by COVID-19 virus, so means that the other part will be for the doctors to figure out a cure for the current patients. So the difference between my idea and the cure thing, okay, the cure thing, I leave it to the doctors. I'm not a doctor, I'm not even a pharmacist, I don't have any relation with the medicine stuff, okay? So my idea is about how to control spreading out the COVID-19 to people, okay? So this is the main point, is to have the 24 hours lockdown, close the public transport. Now, for all the people around the world, they have 2 reasons, okay? Because all the governments around the world, they are saying to the people, you can't go outside your home unless you have a reason. So the only reason that any person can have, so the only reasons that any person could say to the policeman in a roadblock or something, they say, I need to go to the clinic, I'm going to the hospital, I'm going to buy some groceries. So all of this one, I can solve it. I can solve all these reasons. So it means that there will be no one on the streets without a permission. Means like that. Okay, I'm gonna solve each part alone. Okay, the first part is about the food, about the groceries. And each supermarket supposed to prepare some kind of application on the phone or a website website or a hotline numbers. Means, okay, but before all of this, within 3 to 4 days, all countries supposed to get ready for this idea. This idea needs to get ready for it first, then you can start doing it, actually. Okay, so in the first 3 to 4 days about this part, okay, they're supposed to say to their citizens in the news about the, this idea in specific. Let me say the idea of 3 to 4 days at the end of the video. Okay, so for now, about the food, all supermarkets, the non-supermarkets or even the unknown supermarkets, they're supposed to show to the people around the news or social media or use any kind of marketing so they can tell the people, okay, that we provide a delivery. So let's say the non-supermarket, they did the application or the website or the hotline numbers, okay, to show to the people so they can order anything so it can be delivered to the home. So the groceries, we can't close the grocery, okay, and we can't close the restaurants, so the restaurants will remain open and even the groceries, but no one will go there and take their food. Everything will be delivered. Even some kind of restaurant, they are open for takeaway. No, all restaurants, the one that they want to open will be available for delivery also to the people. So this is the point about the restaurants and the known markets. They're supposed to use application, hotline numbers or a website to order food. Each place is supposed to prepare like the car with a fridge or whatever to deliver food, the cold food or the hot food or whatever it is. So this is for the food part. Second part is about medicine. How am I going to get my medicine from the pharmacy? So each pharmacy also supposed to get ready for that, to get ready for a car, for to bring a car for delivery or a motorbike for delivery, whatever it is. Okay, each pharmacy they supposed to have a solution, but this is not my business to choose. Oh, they need to bring a motorbike. No, I'm not talking about this, but I'm talking about the main idea that each pharmacy supposed to have a delivery service. So let's say you got a letter from the doctor, you send it by WhatsApp. Let's say by WhatsApp or by the website or by the application to the pharmacy, so they can prepare your order and then send it to your place. So this is about the medicine. Let's say now it's about the clinic. Okay, how am I going to the clinic? So in each area now there will be a lot of doctors available staying there, or even if that area they don't have a doctor living in that area, so the government supposed to divide the doctors around the country to choose a clinic there or to choose a place where they can stay for the whole lockdown, different operation time. And then if let's say one of the neighbors there, so they got sick or something, their stomach is feeling pain or they feel crazy headache or whatever, so this is not that hard situation for the patient to go to the hospital for a headache or stomach pain, whatever. The one who will decide if that's a serious case or no, the doctor. So the doctor will come at your house. You don't go to the clinic, you don't go to the clinic outside, the doctor will come to your house. So after the doctor will come to your house and check if you are suspected in COVID-19, so they will directly call an ambulance for you, okay, to go to the hospital that is made for the COVID-19 cases. Okay, I'm gonna talk about the temporary hospitals after that. So if let's say your case is not that serious and you just need to take medicine, so the doctor will write the medicine for you and then you send it to the pharmacy and then the pharmacy will deliver it to you. So if you don't have that serious case, you're not allowed to go outside your home. Even though now you have a serious case, okay, let's say that you have a serious case, the doctor will write a permission letter to you actually, so you can send it to the hospital, so the hospital can send you an ambulance. You are not allowed to move outside your home by yourself, because you need to go outside your home in a safe way and go back to your home in a safe way. So who can guarantee that? The ambulance. So the ambulance will take you to the hospital and then they will check you if you are suspected in COVID-19. So you will go to those departments that is specialized in COVID-19 cases. If you are not, then you will get your cure, then you will get the checkup and everything, and then they will send you back to your home. That's the safe move, the safe idea, because you can't guarantee for any person that will go to the hospital is totally safe. Some patients, while they are going to the hospital, they might get COVID-19 virus, but you can't know that actually until 14 days finishing, or after a while you will know that. But if let's say he went to the hospital and then with just one cough, you don't know how many other patients will get infected by this one. You don't know. You can't guarantee this. Because this thing you can't see, right? So if this thing you can't see means that I can't risk with 1%. Means everything's supposed to be under control. 100% under control. So that is the idea how the patient can move to the hospital if it's a serious case. So if this patient need to see a specialist, this is the only way. So no one will go alone to anywhere. This is about how they will go to the hospital. Other thing about the temporary hospital, that each country is supposed to prepare like a lot of temporary hospitals. In each city, there is one temporary hospital at least, okay? It's better than bringing the COVID-19 patient, okay? And then they go to the hospital. So they will be seen by a normal doctor. Then until you know that this patient is suspected by corona, until you know that, you don't know how many people inside the hospital will get infected by that guy because you didn't take the enough procedures, the safety procedures against that person. So you can't guarantee that. So the only way you make a lot of temporary hospitals in many cities, so if that person is suspected with corona, or if anyone feels that I might be suspected by corona or COVID-19 virus, so I go directly to that temporary hospital, because over there they are well prepared to receive any numbers of corona patients. So what I'm saying is we need to be prepared for the worst thing that could happen. You just imagine that you are in a zombie land. So you are in a zombie land, so you don't want to risk with one bite of one zombie, but this one will keep on spreading out to another person. Then no human will be alive. Think about it in that way. That is the reason from the temporary hospitals to avoid being crowded in the hospital between the COVID-19 patients and the normal patients. So this is now for the temporary hospitals, and also each hospital supposed to prepare cars to transport the doctors going and back from hospital to home and from home to their hospital. Okay, why? You need to guarantee their safety, because if they are not totally protected from COVID-19, then it's also risky. If any of the doctors or any of the hospital workers got the COVID-19, then that means that the COVID-19 can be spread out inside the hospital itself. That will be a big problem. That will be a disaster, actually. So people supposed to go to the hospital to get a cure or whatever, to get recovered. So imagine that I'm going to the hospital and then I don't have corona, then I get corona from the hospital because there is one of the workers there got the COVID-19, but I didn't know until after the 14 days. So that's the main problem also. So we need to guarantee that all the workers inside the hospital are totally protected from COVID-19. You need to guarantee that. Not just the doctors, actually the doctors and also the policemen. Because those who are controlling the streets from people and controlling the lockdown idea, and also the doctors, those who are the people who are sacrificing their lives actually against something they cannot see. So all of them, they need to be well prepared and they need to be well protected. You can give all of them a suit, a medical suit, whatever, but you just need to make sure that they are totally protected. Even those who are on the street, like, because a lot of policemen, of course, in many countries they are doing the police block, the road block. Okay, so if let's say one of the drivers got COVID-19, that would be a problem. While the policeman is asking, "Where are you going, sir?" I get the COVID-19 from him. You don't know because you can't see it. Then that policeman give it to his colleague. So that would be a big problem. So you need to get them well prepared and well protected from this COVID-19 virus. So now I just need to confirm about the permission. So no one will go to the hospital without a permission from the doctor. No one will go to the bank. Okay, there is some jobs in all the countries that you can't. There is few jobs in many countries, in all countries actually, like the bank. You can't close a bank, like 100% closed. So there will be few workers that they have to go there to check some papers or whatever. So those people, they need to go there with an official letter with them so they can show to the police roadblock. Now, if let's say you want to go to the bank, withdraw or make cash deposit, you can't go to the bank unless if you got an appointment through an SMS or something. No one will be on the street without a permission, without an appointment, without an evidence that I'm going to that place and I have an appointment from 3 to 4, for example, and then I'll go back straight away to my home. Everything's supposed to be organized. everything's supposed to be on time, everything's supposed to be well protected. Okay, for those places that will be open while the lockdown is working, let's say also the police stations, the hospitals, the clinics that will have those doctors waiting in each area. So you have to prepare all of them very well with the medical part. Means, let me explain. Because I saw a video before in Indonesia that there is, you know, this kind of gates that we pass through in the airports. So I saw a video in Indonesia, okay, those people are going to pray, they just raise their hands like that, and there's kind of fan, but this fan have material, I don't know what is it, but some kind of sanitizer, I think, and then they are totally clean to go inside. So they are making sure that you don't have any virus in your hand or something, and then you can go inside. So we need to prepare all of this kind of technology in all of those places that they will be open while the lockdown is there. Let me talk about another point. So those who will go to those places, I know they will have this kind of gate that you will make sure that they are totally clean when they go inside. Those workers, if one of them felt not okay, if even they just did like at home one cough, or they got flu, or they got headache, so they supposed to apologize, I'm not gonna be able to go to work, I think I have something. So those who go there, that they are 100% clean, 100% without any disease, they are not sick at all, those who are able to go to the work. So that is the only way. And also, we all know that there is a lot of available jobs, is working from home, you can work from your house. So don't think about the economy. Don't be that afraid. We still have working from home. Don't worry that much about economy. Actually, money come and go. But the problem is, when you lose people's lives, you can't turn back. Okay, so now, within this month, we need to use the streets are totally empty from the morning until night. And we clean all the streets by using an alcoholic thing, or I don't know what kind of components that you need to use it to clean all the COVID-19, to kill the COVID-19 on the streets. So you need to clean all the roads in many cities, all the roads everywhere inside the country. The same one as they did in China also. So that one was totally good, because one of the main reasons for spreading out the COVID-19 is through the ground, is through the roads, outdoor thing, okay, not just the indoor. It's not about the malls, it's not about the cinema, it's not about all these places, because COVID-19 you can find it anywhere. So I need to make sure that I cleaned everywhere inside the city, because so after, when we finish all this lockdown period of time, after we kill that COVID-19, after we find the cure, so like this we can guarantee that after we finish the lockdown, no one can get the COVID-19 through the ground or whatever. So now, within 3 to 4 days, what all the countries should do? They're supposed to inform the people about using social media, using the news, using whatever, but all citizens in each country, they're supposed to know this idea to start working on it. Let's say each person from each house, there is one person supposed to go to the grocery and bring food as much as they can for the longest period of time. Okay, so let's say if they could bring for 3 weeks at least. So the last week, what they will do, they use the delivery one for food. Okay, so they need also to get ready with many cars, many hospital cars, many ambulances, many temporary hospitals. So they're supposed to build all of this in each city. They're supposed to get ready also with another cars, a lot of cars to clean the roads. They're supposed to make sure of all of that is ready as soon as possible. Okay, so we can succeed with this idea. All countries, they're supposed to do that together at once. They can do any kind of agreement or a deal, like those kind of meetings when a lot of countries, they meet each other, all the presidents, they meet each other and do a deal. Okay, so if let's say one of the countries refuse to proceed with this idea, so the rest need to cut any connection with this country. Okay, because I'm not gonna risk with my people after I finish the corona, after I kill the COVID-19, I'm not gonna risk with my people dealing with you, then somehow I get COVID-19 again because of this country, because this country didn't follow. So all countries must do that together, must get ready together, must prepare for the idea together. So I hope that, I think I missed some parts. I hope that I said most of the parts that I wanted to say. Please guys, cooperate, okay, and tell me your opinion. If you got any questions about my idea, you can just comment below or you send me a message, or you just can use the hashtags, okay, by saying your opinion. I'm afraid if I miss something, so please guys, stay safe, stay at home, okay, don't risk with 1%, because this thing is cannot be seen. And guys, please share so we can show the video to as many people as we can. Thank you.